Hey, it's Nathan, and today I wanted to go ahead and share with you that one of the research projects that I mentored as a graduate student is now a preprint on the archive. So it's available to read there on the archive and also on ResearchGate as well. I worked with Dr. Kalamura to help mentor two undergraduates as we looked at a one-parameter family of self-affine functions introduced by Okamoto back in 2005. Now, depending on the value of the parameter, the function that's derived from these functional equations ends up falling into different differentiability slash nowhere differentiability classes. And at its most intuitive level, the nowhere differentiable functions and their calculus are of interest to us because a majority of continuous functions end up being, in terms of category, nowhere differentiable. So we focused on a particular case of this calculus when the parameter was just a third. And the reason for that was because it's analogous to a situation that Hara and Yamaguchi studied. So what they did is that they looked at Lebesgue's singular function, which is a very similarly defined family of self-affine functions that are defined by one parameter, and they were able to make a connection to Takagi's function or the blancmange curve. Which is a pretty accessible example of a Durham curve from fractal geometry. And the way that they made this connection was by looking at the partial derivative of Lebesgue's singular function with respect to the parameter at the value of the parameter that Lebesgue's singular function just spit out the identity function. It turns out that that value for Lebesgue's singular function is the parameter equal to 1/2, and for us, it was the parameter equal to 1/3. So, because the things were defined similarly, we thought we could do a similar analysis. So, the function that we derive from this analysis, we end up calling k of x, and it's a pretty nice example of a nowhere differentiable function, as it is a continuous, nowhere differentiable odd function whose points with infinite derivative turn out to give an example of a set of measure zero that also has Hausdorff dimension one. We were also able to nicely characterize the cases where infinite derivatives occur based on the ternary expansion of the function's input value. There's a handful of different types of analysis in math that we encountered while working on this paper, ranging from classical analysis to fractal geometry, measure theory, and a little bit of number theory that has to do with the digit distribution of numbers in a given expansion on the unit interval. So that was kind of interesting to see while working through the project. And if you're interested in taking a look at it, again, it's on the archive and it's also on ResearchGate. I've linked it down below as well. And if everything in this little short little advertisement for a project that I worked on sounded like gibberish, I've also gone through and linked to different articles and things that go over some of the basics of what is necessary to have a better idea of what I'm talking about and what is in the paper as well. So that's all linked in the description below too. Thanks for watching this short video that was also a test of something else and also is a little blurb about research things that I've been working on. If you do end up taking a look at the preprint, just drop a comment. It would be really nice to hear about some of the math that I assisted with in down there as well. But anyway, as always, I'm Nathan. This one was a different type of chocolate, and I will see you next time.